So jittery. Alright, we'll just do it. Why is it? Hey everyone, welcome to Kip TV. I am Kip, and today I've got a match for you. A blast from the past, if you will. Also an Arctic blast from the past. Oh yeah, we're on Arctic. I bet you saw that one coming. Anyway, it is Swordfish Trombones versus Trollbait 2 Steel Blue Teams from North America, I believe. Maybe they're European? I don't remember. Anyway, so this is from a few months ago, so I'm just now getting into it. Sorry about that, guys. But we'll see. I heard it was a good one. Swordfish Trombones is in red, I believe, yes. We have a Navigator as demo, MF Snapper is Pyro Wicket, in very small print right there is Engineer Etty Bagig, I'm gonna call him Eddie, hashtag Titty Sprinkles, which is funny, is Scout Deacon Frost, is Spy Cream, is Medic, Frontward Enemy is Soldier, the Custodian is Sniper, and Pete's PTEF BSD is Heavy. Over on blue team, Trollbait, we have Charlie Cat as Engineer, the Dream Traveler as Spy, Irish Otter Pops is Demo, Harroquin is Heavy, AU is Soldier, Fluttershy is Medic, Tarandol is Pyro, Owie is Scout, and Linko is Sniper. Let's get onto a Demo Man cam, because you're usually the most fun to watch on these King of the Hill rollouts. Irish Otter Pops doesn't have the right thing out. You can't roll out with a bottle, silly Irish Pops. He really wants to use that bottle, but I don't think it's going to work for him on this, so he's gonna get out there a little bit slowly, but don't worry, his scout is out there, and red team actually getting out there quite early, probably running their whip with their soldier. I wouldn't be surprised, but they're gonna go for this tunnel hold here on the left. Meanwhile, red spy is getting in behind the flank, so we'll have to watch them as he has got some good positioning. He has spotted out the medic, and he is in perfect position, and down goes Fluttershy. So Deacon Frost getting Fluttershy and Harroquin right there, so huge picks from the red team onto the blue team, and red should be able to push out here with little problem. Cream is alive with that 100% crits, actually popped it right there because he took some damage, so we'll be able to clear out anything that blue has left of their mid fight, which is not too much right now. Dispenser goes down, took out AU as well, so this is not a great opening mid fight from Trollbait. They're going to have to get things together, but really losing that medic and heavy combo obviously devastated them, so can't do too much. Pete was scared by the wee little sentry gun, and he had decided to back off from that, which, I mean, I'm just joking, of course. Mini sentries are very scary, but he also had his medic on him and didn't want to lose his medic to the mini sentry, and then, of course, the rest of the blue team was pushing forward, so I understand. I'm just giving you shit, Pete. Pete did just go down to a backstab, so now I feel sorry about talking about him behind his back. Huh, backstab, get it, back. Anyway, blue team pushing out from there, able to get some good positioning. We're going to have this crits ready for red team soon, though. Fluttershy goes down, front toward enemy with a rocket onto the point. Didn't see it on camera, but saw it on the kill feed, so taking out. Oh, and then Cream goes down. I am just on the worst cameras for this action, but both medics going down, very close to crits right there. So let's watch the AU camp. He is on his opponent's crates right there. You can tell because they are red. So being very aggressive right there, trying for a front hold, which is a good idea. And that's generally the role the soldiers play on Arctic, is to patrolling those crates and denying this area to the opposing team. So he's definitely playing that role good. We'll see. Roll well. Here we go. So we'll see if he can continue to help out his team as blue is continuing to hold on to this point. Just now lapsed time from red. So Swordfish Trombones losing that momentum they had in the very beginning. We'll see if they can pick it back up. Deacon Frost getting there behind lines, but he was caught out. Cream did have a crits advantage, but he went down. That's it. I just need to stick on these medics because they're having a very, very hard time staying alive. Generally, if that's usually the case, you may want to go regular Uber. It looks like we do have... Stop running around. Yes, we do have regular Uber from blue, so that's really interesting. I do like that decision. It is going to charge a little bit slower, but keep that medic safe. You're going to have that Uber ready to go, and you can push in, of course, with invulnerability. Looks like that's what Trollbait wants to do. We will see if they do commit themselves to this push. Harroquin is... he actually lost his medic there. Fluttershy did not follow him onto the point, so he took a lot of damage and went down. So lost that heavy right there. I'm not certain about if that was miscommunication or what happened right there, because you really don't want to lose your heavy when you have that 100% Uber ready to go. Looks like we do have 100% something ready to go here for red. It does look like the crits, so that Uber is going to have to be popped before that crits. Here it comes, and first goes off, and down goes Fluttershy. Huge, huge crits right there. Oh man, but down goes Cream, taken out by Owie, the scout. But regardless, that crits didn't work. Only two alive now for Blue, and they are just now getting those respawns. So an excellent push right there, a perfect execution of the crits, and easy for me to say, but really should have popped that Uber sooner, Fluttershy, but of course, that's always the case. But it was just really well done. We're going to take it on the Deacon Frost cam. Hashtag Escaliers, which is stairs in French, if I'm not mistaken. Oh! Miss... Oh, no! It makes up for that. Miss Backstab takes down Fluttershy again. Poor medics. These rounds, or this first round, have just had a tough time. Speaking of tough titties, there goes Etty, as he tries to make something happen there. But, Red Team still has quite a bit of time left to hold on here for. Blue came back really strong after that first round, after that first mid-fight. So we'll see if Red can put up this strong defense. With that crits charging pretty fast and Fluttershy going down, they're going to have another advantage very soon right here. So we'll see if they can't have another miracle crits. We'll get on the Demo Man cam Navigator and see if he can't navigate successful crits. Or something like that. He gets the pop. Oh, spotted at the med. Can he get the pick? Oh my goodness, Fluttershy is so lucky right now. But finally, Navigator connects. Takes out Fluttershy. He missed the first, or Fluttershy danced around the first two crit stickies, but could not escape that last one. So really nice right there from Navigator. Judged that distance correctly and was able to take out that medic. So only a minute left now for Swordfish Trombones to hold on to this point. But of course, Trollbait wanting to do everything to stop that. Trollbait. Now are they... Oh, okay, I get it. I get the name. Don't worry, guys, I get it. I don't get Swordfish Trombones. I'm assuming it's a joke. But I'm concerned about Trombones playing Swordfish. Anyway, crits coming out. Pete just mowing down three rides there. Fluttershy did escape alive. Remember, Fluttershy, I think, is on this Uber still. So if they can get an Uber to come back, but they did just lose their heavy right there. Heroquin going down. We'll get... No, Fluttershy's on the crits. Okay, so that... If they can get it up, and if Irish... Otter Pops can get that crits and well-placed, this could be... Still opportunity for Blue to come back. Times are just now even at 19 seconds. Here is the crits. It needs to be popped very, very soon. Fluttershy still has it. There are no crits. Sticky's coming down. Irish Pops is getting these kills. We need to get the crits. It's actually going to be popped on the soldier. Interesting decision right there. We'll see if it works. It's turned now to the heavy. But no one notices the red soldier from behind and down. Front towards enemy takes three kills right there before he finally goes down. A little bit of a sketchy push right there from Blue. They will be able to take this point, but I think they could have done a lot more casualty damage, i.e. like taking down more people, if they had popped on the Demo Man, because Navigator had some really nice positions on his stickies, but they just weren't crits. Here we go with Red and their last push. They have a crit that is raging. Nobody's able to get onto the point, though, and front toward enemy went down to a backstab right there, and so did Navigator. Oh, wow. And I'm sorry, I said Navigator was Blue Team Demo before, but he is not, obviously. That is the Irish Otter Pops guy. But Blue Team did a good job defending the point right here. Front Door Enemy coming in! Oh man, everyone was so hurt on the point! Front Door Enemy getting another 3k! We'll see if he can come in here and help get on the point, because the time is so, so not going to make it. Oh, so Blue Team coming back with a strong victory right there, and a strong, strong defense in the last few seconds. Very... Very fun and well done. We're going to watch Front Toward Enemy. He got some of those big defensive rockets at the end. Getting 6Ks in about 1 minute. So we'll give him some camera time to see what he can do. Gets out to mid very fast right here. But we do have a pause. I was aware of it. Don't worry. I'm on this, guys. 1-3-9-3-0-0. I won't be able to edit this out because I've mentioned before I have no more room on my computer, so I have to upload everything directly from Twitch, so I'm sorry about that. But, I have no money to buy more memory. So anyway, front door enemy took a lot of damage right there. I'm not even sure what happened, but he will go down a point right now. It's pretty much abandoned, as we do have teams pretty much staying on their own sides, except we do have a scout and, the Dream Traveler in here behind for the blue team, trying to make something happen. Blue Scout is in here, and harassing the Engineer could be fun. Engie misses the punch, so that's not going to do anything, and Owie actually does go down. He gets an Owie. That is, So Cream is close to this crits right now. It has 100%. Looks like Fluttershy went down, so he does not have this, so we're going to get in on this camera. Remember, nobody has capped the point yet. Pointed is what I was going to say. I think we could make pointed a verb in terms of TF2. No one has pointed the point. Anyway. This will be a cap for red. They still haven't popped that crit. It wouldn't be a bad idea to pop it right now as soon as that blue medic is caught out. But they've been holding on to it for quite a bit right now. And usually the crits, when you pop it, when you get it, you want to pop it. They have allowed time for Fluttershy now to build up his crits, and they are on the point, so they are in a better position, and Fluttershy gets AU and a rocket to connect, taking down Cream, and now they're just going to hold on to this positioning. Down goes Heroquin, so maybe not hold on to the positioning, but did buy a little bit of time for themselves on the point. We'll see if Blue can come back, but right now it's just the Spy and Scout, it looks like, though Wicket has a mini sentry. And he's got that Frontier Justice. Oh no, not going to be able to do so. Owie does take him down. Owie actually getting a 2k right there. Need to get on his cam if he's... Nope, he went down. Of course he did. Sorry about that. So sorry about that. It's a little pause in the action. Well, I guess it's action happening. Blue is taking the point. That's exciting if you're on the blue team. So Trollbait coming back. Oh, but Deacon Frost getting the backstab on Heroquin, so no heavy. Fluttershy, meanwhile, took a lot of damage from that. Had to fall back from the point. So Blue, though they did capture the point, they don't have a lot of good presence on it. They won't be able to really defend right here. Oh, and especially now when Deacon Frost is just running rampant. Leading the server right now in points. Going a little bit crazy. But that means... That's good for his team, obviously. Obviously. So that just means the other team has to start watching their backs. More spy checking. More being aware of these flanks. Oh, man. Pete had to spend so much of that crit on that mini sentry. And then in comes Harquin and Owie actually helping out to clean up. But down goes Fluttershy again. Gotta watch those backs. And Deacon Frost is just taking really good advantage of when people aren't watching. So we're going to get on his cam in just a minute when he gets back up and into some interesting positioning. Interesting position. Because he's been doing doing some work right there. But Blue did come back. They were able to hold on to the point right there. So about 145 left for them. And now let's get on to the Deacon Frost went down. Okay. All right. I wonder if he's a real deacon. I bet he's not. Of course, I don't know what the qualifications are to be a real deacon are. Just, again, going to give a quick shout-out to Dell, my friend who made me this awesome HUD customized. Little bit of XTV HUD, little bit of TF.TV HUD. All KIP TV, though. That's what it is. And it's beautiful. Because I was just thinking about the outlines. And you can see where the spies are. So good. So good. So good. Anyway, blue team... Deacon just had another kill right there, so we have to get on his camera. I'm sorry. Have to flip through. Sorry. Alright, we're gonna get on the Cream cam, who just popped that crits just in time on Heroquin, who's... or Pete! No, I'm sorry. Pete. Pete the Red Heavy, pushing blue team back, and they now have less than a minute, blue does, on the point to go. But Deacon Frost, there we go. Finally, we're on the Deacon Frost cam. And he likes stairs. He likes French stairs. Oh, man. Thought he was safe right there, but Owie caught him out. So good checking right there from Blue Scout. Help his team out. Obviously important. But Red now having a little bit of trouble containing the point. They do have time on it. They do have some presence, but if you look, just look at the outlines, the blue is just kind of like enveloping the point right now. They're on all sides, including from behind, so that Scout and Spy have really been working the flanks, working the back flanks. the butt, if you will. I don't know if that's proper. But we do have this crits ready to go for both teams. Needs to be popped, and there it goes. Navigator with a huge crit hill. We'll see if they can clean up, and Fluttershy actually goes down to Wicket, who came after him with the Frontier Justice. Wicket got a 2k right there, goes down to Linko, but Linko gets sniped by the Custodian, so the circle of life is complete, and Red will defend for a little bit longer. They have 40, 39, 38 seconds left in this round. Remember, there's 1-0. Trollbait is in the lead, but that was a pretty darn close first round, and this one looks like it's going to be pretty darn closer as we wait for Blue to make their last move. They don't have a lot of time. They probably won't be able to wait for a crits or any sort of uber advantage. They have a little bit of a player advantage right now that they could work off, but it's not going to be huge as Red will eventually get these respawns, but Blue does need to move. They don't have enough time to hang out. They are going to push forward right here. Fluttershy goes down. Navigator with some big stickies. Oh, and here comes the crits. That is going to seal the nail in the coffin, I think, unless this NG and Spy can go huge. Oh, Spy was on the point, but he was disguised, so the point capture was not delayed. So that brings it to 1-1. Another good round between these two very well-matched teams. So awesome to see that when they're so closely matched in skill level that it's not a roll. King of the Hill is probably the best for when you have two really well-matched teams. Right now we're just going to watch Eddie Bag as he's trying to find his opposing scout. Finally found him. He decided to touch to the ground and not fly anymore. But whoever gets this med pack is going to get this battle victory. And oh man, but here comes the Spy, and it's not even fair anymore. Eddie is trying to do the best he can, but he does go down. So he has to call out that there are two blue players behind the lines. Again, they're just doing that, taking advantages of those flanks, many outside opportunities that Arctic offers. Outside and under. Whereas, as you can see, Red Team is just pretty much clustered around that hallway. Here comes the crits! Oh! 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 Ouchie wawa, indeed. As a huge crits comes down from Red Team, annihilates Blue Team. Fluttershy went down right there. And only a few up as Red will very nicely take that in the first capture of this round. So, we will see if they could hold on. Ah, sorry, I had a mid-yawn in that sentence. It's because I slept too many hours last night and still too tired. But this game is super exciting, so I'm slowly waking up. Don't worry, ladies and gentlemen. Red, still gonna keep with their positioning in this tunnel. They really like it. I guess you could call it hallway tunnel. Again, since Arctic was only played the first time this year, I'm not sure if there's any standard name calls in terms of, like, the whole league. I'm sure teams develop their own position calls for, you know, crates, hallway, room, stuff like that. This, I think, is shack or shed or house. I don't know. Maybe it's a mansion, I mean, depending on where you live. Oh, man, Cream taking a ton of rocket spam. Somehow survives and doesn't pop his crit, so that was well played from him. Fluttershy lost his heavy right there, and so close to this crits as well. It looks like they wanted to push off of that. They do pop the crits. We'll see if they can get anything, but no! Oh, Navigator comes in with his own crits. Oh man, that was some nice sticky work taking down Charlie Cat as he's run away. So Navigator's been doing huge work right here. Oh man, and Miss Snapper MF takes down Harlequin as well. We do have a scout at a point for Blue, so just Red Team being very aggressive after kind of wiping Blue out right there. They're just gonna push forward into spawn a little bit. We have seen that they have been less aggressive than the Blue Team, and the Blue Team gets the point. They have been more willing to really push in or push back the opposing team closer to their spawn. But we are going to watch the Dream Traveler cam right now. Oh, he says. Oh man, he took a lot of damage right there, so probably won't be able to do anything with this. He rockets coming down from front toward enemy, takes down Fluttershy, so he was utilizing those crates right there to get that height difference. So really nice work right there, and then Deacon Frost comes in from behind, finishes off that heavy. We still have a soldier on the point, but down goes AU as he gets finished off by Navigator, and Red Team now is just appear to be doing everything right, and Blue Team just can't get their bearings together. So gonna be a tough tough round to overcome for Trollbait if they want to win. Of course they want to win. Of course they want to. What kind of question is that? But they do need to get their act together because there's only 20 seconds left. Only 20 seconds. 10 seconds. I've been stuttering for 10 seconds. Okay, that's great. But Fluttershy, blue team, just not having any player presence. They're not going to be able to get in here as red. Oh, still holding in pretty significantly well to the point there's heavy medic there, and that is going to be the end of the third round. 2-2-1. Poop is in the lead. Also known as Swordfish Trombones. Let's see. We watched his rollout last time. Let's get a blue rollout. Owie. Howie is doing pretty well on his team. He's, like I said, he and this spy have a really big going in behind the red flanks, or red lines, trying to just harass from the back. With that, you'll sometimes get some nice picks and pick off wounded players who are, you know, falling back to get health or ammo or something like that. So Howie could be getting lots of his stuff from there. He has found that teleporter, you know, also getting points for taking down poor defenseless teleporters. But yeah, he's in behind these lanes right now, harassing Engineer. We'll see. He's also found out the Medic doesn't have a lot of ammo loaded right here, but he can call this out that the Medic is pretty vulnerable. Maybe he and a spy can do something right here, but right now just taking pot shots at the Engineer that will distract the Scout enough. We'll see as Red tries to push in right here. They have this 100% crits popped immediately, but oh, no good as Irish Otter Pops had Cream right in his sight lines, and he and Navigator... Otter Pops and Navigator, I mean, Cream and Navigator, there we go down into some nice sticky traps from Otter Pops. There we go. That's what I was trying to say. So Blue, coming back from that, definitely Irish Otter Pops doing the big work right there and taking out the crits from Red Team that could have done a lot of damage. Oh, Deacon Frost getting some heals and then getting some heavy. And down it goes, poor heavy on point, Heroquin. We do have the crits coming off for Blue. The first sticky miss is a little too short, and down goes... Fluttershy right there. I thought he went down before he did, but no, that's Tarindol, who is the pyro who is trying to do something right there. But he went down after the exchange, or in the middle of the crits exchange, so not able to help out right there. So Blue a little frustrated with what's going on right now, and Heroquin... Oh, he's so close to getting this heavy. Oh, but he was stuck in a position that made him prime beef for Deacon Frost. And Deacon Frost was hungry and just cut up some beef, I guess. As you can see, he's been doing some crazy amounts of work as spy. So we'll have to get on his cam in just a second. We'll get on his cam right. Oh, we have a crits ready to go. So we'll get on Navigator's cam. That's what we'll do. Sorry, just the plans are also confusing. Oh, he spotted out the medic. Oh, the stupid sticky got caught on the crate. Down goes Tarot. Oh, and he does connect. Finally connects with Fluttershy right there, chasing him. But really nice crits right there. Navigator has got these crits down. He doesn't panic. He doesn't just spam. He carefully places where they need to be. And very intelligent demo man action going on right there. Blue team has been a little more... Owie just hates these teleporters. He's got something against the teleporters. But Blue Team has been a little bit more scattered with their crits, just popping on whoever seems to be near, but they have been very effective with some of them. So, just different ways of using the crits. Depends on your playstyle, depends on the player's experience and their comfort level. Also, a lot of variables, so no way is right, no way is wrong. We do have Cream close to this crit as well. Or crits soon, so we'll probably be seeing this pushback for Blue. They have a 140, and this has been probably a Trollbait stronger round. However, they lost Heroquin right there. Heroquin has been caught out of position several times. Here comes the crits again from Red. Oh, wow! The medic was distracted by the crits. In comes a scout trying to pick the medic off from behind. Fluttershy only has about 50 health left. Eddie was not able to take him out, but in comes Blue Team taking back the point. Very good push right there. They were able to do some nice work, get some nice kills, and really recover from what could have been devastating. The fact that Fluttershy survived the crits attack and then the scout attack is very significant right there. We're going to watch some AU cam. AU, of course, What do these players have against teleporters? And I like that teleporter spot though. It's very, very sneaky. But it hasn't been able to stay up. So maybe time to reconsider where the teleporter location should be. Oh, Heroquin getting this crits just in time. Will he be able to take out the heavy? He's doing a lot of damage, and oh, goes down. Deacon Frost takes advantage of his narrow-sightedness and stabs him in the back, as Blue still has the point, though, so Red needs to recover from that, or needs to take advantage of Blue's misstep right there and get on the point. It looks like Deacon Frost doing it all right now, so okay, all right. I will not fight it anymore. Let's just stick on your camera until you die. As he is trying to get on to the point, he needs to get on to the point. Like, all these backstabs are all well and good, but he needs the rest of his team to help out and get some time. Oh, he spotted a heavy. Gets that pick on the heavy. Medic was right behind him, so you kind of question, like, which is better, to get the heavy or the medic? But in that situation where the heavy is pushing forward, putting down a lot of damage, you definitely want the heavy right there. Fluttershy is close to crits, but not there yet. And Red will be able to cap this and take us into overtime for Blue. Despite Charlie Cat's best efforts. Oh, but then the Dream Traveler, not too shabby of a spy himself, taking down the heavy on the point and with no heavy right there. But oh, Deacon Frost. Did he get those kills? I think he got credit for them, but regardless, Fluttershy and the heavy went down, but nobody is alive for Red. There's only 50 seconds left for Swordfish Trombones to hold on to this point, but Trollbait has to just capture it and they will win this round. Remember, it is 2-1. Swordfish are in the lead, but there's nobody here for Swordfish to come back and take this, and it will go to the team tagged up as Four Pony, also known as Trollbait. So there we go, another extremely close round from these two teams. Absolutely ridiculous. Let's get on the Navigator cam, see if he does a roulette. Looks like he has plans for that. I don't know if there's any like standard rollout on Arctic for Demo Man. Probably run into the roof is not a part of it, but don't worry, Navigator, there's still plenty fine, though he does take a lot of damage. But Fluttershy goes down to Eddie, so Eddie doing some flanking action right there, trying to get in from behind. Look at this positioning from Blue. They're just being super, super aggressive, getting in behind. Or, I'm sorry, Red is being really, really aggressive. Blue is pushing from behind as well. You can see they're everywhere. But these both teams have just been exchanging players across the lines. They don't even care that you're not supposed to go on the other team's side. They have no respect for personal space. Especially front toward enemy right here, who has spotted at the enemy medic. Put his front toward the enemy and make him shoot. Nope, not going to happen on Heroquin's watch. We do have crits ready to go for Red. Nobody's capped the point yet. That's significant. Oh, crits comes off in perfect timing. Able to take Heroquin, but oh, you heard that noise. That means Cream went down to a headshot right there. We haven't caught any sniper action on camera, so we'll have to get some of that in just a bit. But a nice snipey snipe from Blue Sniper. Linko takes down that medic in the midst of that crits. Can't underestimate or overstate the importance of that. I don't know. I don't know what the word was right there. But we'll get to Linko's cam and see what he can't do for his team right now as they are trying to push in. Taking down the opposing sniper, of course, is going to be very significant. Sniper lines on Arctic aren't that bad. I haven't heard any snipers complain about this as much as other maps, but I don't think it's as conducive to sniping as maybe Viaduct. Oh, wow, Eddie was in on the medic. Fluttershy took, gave him some damage, but goes down to Rocket from AU, so good protection of his med right there. Go back to Linko cam, he's just getting into positioning. He painted his apple green! You can't do that! Or is it green on... I don't know. I just don't know anymore what these days are coming to. I also want to talk about Tarandol and the back burner. This is not the first time I've seen the back burner on Arctic, and it makes sense when you consider that Tarandol wanted to go the basement route right there, probably get in behind and use that backburner to the best of its effect. So we'll go see if he can do that in just a minute, but we do have the crits ready to go for Blue, and it looks like they want to push in. Heavy comes out with the Gru, and in comes the Jurati, and down goes Fluttershy. Eddie got in on the med. What's happening there with the protection of Fluttershy? He's just not getting anything. You're surrounded by players. Oh, man. Oh, man, there's just so much that should not be happening right there. Players are just not watching their backs, letting scouts get in, letting spies get in, and that's from both sides. Both sides have been losing their meds to a ridiculous amount. So need to tighten up the screws a little bit, as they say. I don't know what that really means, but watch your backs, guys. Watch your backs, watch your flanks, protect your meds, especially in King of the Hill, especially on a map like this where there is no ammo or no health near mid. You have a half ammo pack, but the nearest health is back in the shed, and it's only a little bottle, so this King of the Hill map, you have to keep your medics alive. Although in general, I do like Arctic, and I think it was a very successful map to have in the regular season rotation. I think everyone pretty much agreed. I don't think there's any huge complaints, at least not like some of the other maps, i.e. Haunt. It was generally accepted that this wasn't too terrible of an idea for UGC to put in their regular rotation, so I'm excited about that. New blood, new life maps that are good. New life, wait, what did I say? New life in maps. It's always fun, but they have to be good. They can't just be Haunt. Front toward enemy, sending a lot of spam towards the point. Wants to distract the pyro while he goes in for the med. Takes down Tarandul, so there goes the pyro. Can they finish off the med? Doesn't even need to. It is Wicket with the Frontier Justice and those mini crits going. He's going to finish a Harlequin the Heavy. What? He's not done. Oh, yeah. Now he is. Poor Wicket, though. He was on quite the little roll until he met a match he could not take down, which was a bunch of stickies. Anyway, though, I'll see if Front Toward Enemy can finish off his opposing soldier, and AU comes out on top with only 18 health left, so pretty darn close. We have this crit ready to go for Red, so we'll see if Swordfish Trombones can make something out of it. They really should not be holding on to it at this point. The Heavy has dropped down, so I'm wondering if Pete thinks he's going to get this crits. He does get this crits and just starts mowing down people. Down goes Fluttershy, down goes Charlie Cat. Can he get the soldier right behind or beneath him? He does, but now there's a scalping. Oh, owie, taking down Pete right there. Cream went down as well, despite his positioning behind above his Heavy. So I don't know about that. I don't know. When you do position like that, you're obviously protecting your medic, but that means if the Heavy is down here and the medic is up here, the Heavy can't protect the medics behind. So you have to have more support right there. We have a bottle kill. No big deal. Irish Otter Pops taking down Deacon Frost with that melee bottle. Not as good as the pan. Not as good as the ham, but still pretty good because it's food related. It used to be more bottle and drink related melee weapons. Dream Traveler in here behind. Oh snap! Linko got the headshot. Where is Linko? He is right there. Perfect positioning, able to get that shot off. Take down opposing medic. That means Fluttershy is going to have this crits right now. Only about 30 seconds left. We'll stick on the Linko cam because he was doing some sweet stuff. Taking down poor little mini sentry guns who had just learned to live. They just learned what life was, and he cut them down in their prime. But with this, crits popped variably on the pyro, and then flashed around a little bit. Blue team trying to hold on as best as they can, but Trollbait doesn't have a lot of player presence right here, whereas Red is pushing forward very strongly. But don't worry, in comes Soldier from behind, but no! AU is caught out by Navigator, so Red team might be able to do this, but in comes Linko! I should have stayed on his cam. Why did I not stay on his cam? But Strati on the point takes down Heavy Medic. They both get taken down. Blue team trying to come back with anything right here to defend the point because they're so close to winning this round. But no, Swordfish Trombone come back and they will capture it. There's only 30 seconds left. So again, we're going to have another ridiculously close round. Oh my goodness. What are these guys doing to me? Well, actually, I can handle it. My heart's pretty good, I think, at least. Not after TF2, it won't be. Anyway, blue team has to fall back from the point because they don't have their med up here with them. They're not getting these overheals. Fluttershy did go down. Again, need that protection of your medic to stay alive. Oh, I'm just saying that AU comes in and takes down Cream from behind. So Red, looking like they will be able to defend this, but Blue's still putting a bunch of time. So we're going to go into double overtime, ladies and gentlemen. Of course. I mean, why not? No big deal. Fluttershy is out here, but goes down to a backstep. Deacon Frost taking him out. We do have a Heavy on the point, but not paying any attention to the sniper from behind. Lincoln's going crazy, but he finally goes down right there. It is absolute chaos and insanity on here on the point right now, ladies and gentlemen. Red is trying to do anything and everything to get their players on here to prevent blue from capping. Remember, whoever caps first will win this round. In comes the little NG who could. No, Wicket goes down. There's a... Oh, here comes some stronger players from Red. Front door enemy able to defend for a little bit, but down goes Navigator. Front door enemy going down to the mini sentry, and that will finally be Blue's point. Whew, wow. So that will be the first round, or the first half. We have to do it all over again. So yeah, the first half, 3-2. I'm going to write that down because I'm going to forget it. 3-2. Trollbait is in the lead. But again, because I am doing this on Twitch, I won't be able to edit it. So I apologize about that. But yeah, this is how I usually... this is the stuff I usually edit out. Did I have the ready up? I think we did. We're almost ready to charge. So yeah, been a very, very exciting match so far. So Arctic was, I think, in the middle of the season. I don't have the records of these teams at this point, but they were both fairly competitive teams in the blue steel division, meaning like they had a chance for winning it and going on to the playoffs. So I won't tell you what happened, but there we go. We are all set. And just let's take it at 50 speed. It'll be fun to watch it slow-mo, right? That sounds absolutely painful. All right. So we'll go back with this second half. Remember, Trollbait is up 3-2. Swordfish Trombones having to win this. What did I just see? I saw a caber. So Irish Daughter Pops has taken put the bottle away and has brought out the caber. So we're going to watch his cam. Maybe he's going to try for a big sticky jump here, take out the medic. Oh, he is. Can he spot the medic? Oh, he's protected in that darn little thing that they have been doing this whole time. Teams have switched positions. So Swordfish Trombones, who have been on red and, you know, been collaborating. What am I trying to say? Collaborating? They've been gathering in this connector for most of the match, obviously bringing that again to their blue side. We do have 100% Ubers or Kritzes ready for both teams. Let's see who pops first, because whoever pops first will win first, I think. Oh, man, Navigator connecting with Fluttershy. Somehow, the medic didn't get credit for that. Out comes the bottle. Oh, but Cream takes down AU with the needle, so red. Ooh, a very painful loss at mid right there. They had that crits just 2 seconds too late. So especially when the opposing medic does not die at mid and you both are running crits, you have to pop first. It's pretty much essential. And that's what killed the red team right there. Fluttershy going down again. You're just hearing that all sound effects of that medic just dying. It's just so painful. Also, of course, the kill feed. We're going to watch some Custodian cam. As we've gotten some Linko shots on cam. Oh, got that Linko shot on cam as well. Oh, scores were reset, but look at Deacon Frost already with 14 points. What? Are you kidding me? All right, we'll go to your camera. Oh, no, we'll get Linko taken down. Pete, nice shot right there. Oh, then the sentry gun. He's a demon, ladies and gentlemen. If he can actually get a shot off there on Owie. Owie was down to 30 health. But he gets some more health. Does continue on. Crits coming out from blue. Oh my god, I hate the sniper cam because it always messes up the perspective. But there you go. Crits coming off and doing a bunch of stuff that you didn't see on camera. That's what happened right there. Anyway, so blue team again just being extremely dominant in this second half, this second round. So let's get on the Deacon Frost cam, okay? Never mind. As blue still holding on to this point, they did just lose their medic. But red is not in any position to push right here, although they're getting kind of aggressive. MF did call that out, so he was able to push forward. He put some damage down Custodian, then taking out Heroquin. So now we have a med without anybody to heal, and that's going to significantly delay the crits from Fluttershy. Fluttershy actually now taking some damage. Where is that medic that... okay, he went down. Front toward enemy, taking him out to with his shoddy. So that soldier getting, again, behind the lines and losing that heavy, his heavy to a headshot, of course. Part of the reason why he died right there. So protection of medics, ladies and gentlemen, on Arctic. So important. Irish otter popskin and a sweet, sweet flank right here. Nobody sees his hair. It's almost insulting that nobody saw him when he was doing so much damage, but he does finally go down. But only 30 seconds left for blue team to hold on right here. Red can't afford to delay much more, but they can't put together anything as Fluttershy is having a really hard time staying together, staying alive. AU just did a crazy rocket thing. Anyway, so red team will pretty much be throwing anything and everything to the point right now. Here comes Irish Otter Pops, but he goes down. Nobody on red is anywhere near, and there's crits on the point. Navigator takes out Tarandel. He tried to get in there for the last second. That is going to tie it up 3-3. So you know what that means. This is the golden cap round. Whoever wins this will win the match, and it has been a doozy. D-O-O-Z-Y, I think is how you spell doozy, but it has been pretty crazy right here. Let's keep an eye on the mid-fight, because whoever takes the mid-fight has a good chance of continuing that momentum and taking the round. And in this case, the entire shebang, the whole enchilada, if you will, or whole quesadilla, depending on your preference of American-Mexican food. Do have a spy in here behind. Does anybody know him? But no, Dream Traveler gets away with taking out Pete. He did not take out Cream, though. Again, that's one of those decisions you have to make when 1 second, like, do I want the med, do I want the heavy, and then bam, it's too late, you're on fire, and you're dead. That's the life of a spy, right? But Linko is in a good position right here, where he could get a shot off on Cream if Cream would just stop jumping for 1 second. But Cream, of course, has no intention of doing that. Man, Deacon and these spies and these snipers have just been everywhere. So we have this 100% ready to go for both teams. Here comes Blue, pushing forward to the point. Fluttershy went down, Navigator connecting on... Oh, man. Devastating again. Blue looking really good. Swordfish Trombone had some sort of crazy pep talk. Or maybe they just like... I don't even know what happened during the halftime, where they just took shots of focus in, and now they're just really focused. It's a Simpsons reference, if you know. But anyway, so yeah, they're just connecting with all of their crits and getting them in the perfect timing. I think right now, red team has to get that crits, get their medic alive, and go after this tunnel. Completely clear it out, and then try to maintain some sort of presence in there, because right now, Blue having the space of operations is really detrimental to Red's cause. Fluttershy is so hurt right now, and has to watch out. There's tons of spam coming down, and Blue just called their crits. Smallish map, so you will be able to hear that. Crits popped immediately, and they are going after the tunnel, but is it going to be enough? Take down Snapper. Where is Cream? They have not spotted out the medic. Oh, and down goes Fluttershy. Eddie was in on him, and Blue, look at that kill feed, it's just all Blue right now. And now's the crits. Oh my god, Navigator's crit sticky just bounced off of poor Harlequin and then exploded him into a million tiny pieces. Blue team continuing to push forward right here, and they are wanting to seal this now and here and now. However, there's a minute and 30 seconds left, even though it is looking very dominant, very good right now for Swordfish Trombones. Deacon Frost in behind everybody. Oh, he may have been spotted out right there. Looks like he was, but he's gonna do a fancy little stair climb and get out of there. This is why he's doing so well in points. He can stay alive even when he's been spotted out. So red team still knows he's there, but they're not protecting their medic. Oh god, turn around, turn around. Going for the heavy first. He does get the pick. Harlequin is down. So almost... So interesting, he went for the heavy pick right there. I would have thought he'd do the medic, but I don't know. That's just one of those things you make a split-second decision again. We do have... See, he didn't even need to get the medic pick, because out comes the crits. Pete just spraying everywhere, and of course with heavy and crits, those bullets have no fall-off damage, or damage fall-off, however you want to say it. They, even if they're far away, their skin's still going to hurt like they hurt real close up, so lethal, so absolutely lethal. Fluttershy is not going to have any sort of charge in order to move on to this point. Red is going to have to make some sort of crazy move to get people in position to stop this cap. There's only 15 seconds left. The entire match comes down to these 15 seconds. Can Trollbait pull off some sort of miracle victory, or will they have to die a slow death to Swordfish Trombones? Oh, we have one hero, but Tarandel can't do it alone, ladies and gentlemen. That is going to be GG. Swordfish Trombones come back with a wonderful, wonderful victory on a well-played map. Well-played match from both sides, so thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks so much to... Who else? Who do you think sent this in? I'm going to go with the spy who got 43 points in two rounds. So, yes, so thank you to Deacon Frost who sent this in. I'm glad I was finally able to get around to casting it. Yeah, well-played from both teams. And, yeah, that's about it, guys. So thanks so much for watching.